Hi, welcome back to Kids in the Kitchen. Today we're going to be making Mexican pizzas. I personally think that these ones are better than the ones from Taco Bell. First, you have to do the most important step, wash your hands. Now that your hands are all washed, we can get started. But another good tip for my long-haired friends is to put your hair up. You just don't want any hair to get into the food because that's gross. Now we're gonna preheat our oven to 400 degrees Fahrenheit. Now that our oven's preheated, we can start the first step, which is cooking the ground beef. When you're handling raw meat, you need to make sure that you clean up your surface before and after, because you don't want any of the bacteria from the meat to get on the surface, because it could make you sick. All right, what I'm gonna do first is open up the meat. This is ground beef. I'm just taking some kitchen scissors and cutting the top off, just like that. And I'm going to put all of the meat into your skillet, just like this. My skillet isn't on yet. Just shake it in, and since you're using the stove, you should have an adult or big person help you. So now what I'm gonna do is take the meat with a spatula or a wooden spoon, and I'm just going to smash it all up into little pieces, just like this. Now what I'm gonna do is turn on the skillet, just like this, to medium heat. Again, you're gonna wanna have an adult help you with this part. And now that it's on, I'm just gonna continue to break up the beef into a bunch of little pieces. Then what I'm gonna do is just add a little bit of oil into the pan. You can use any oil, such as olive oil or coconut oil. I'm using olive oil. So you're just gonna drizzle a tiny little bit on the top of your meat, and you're gonna continue to break it up. As you can see, it's starting to turn brown. So there's just parts that are turning brown. That is good, that's what we want. When we're finished, we don't want to see any pink. If you see any pink, that means that it's not cooked. So I'm gonna go ahead and cook it, and you gotta keep smashing it. Keep smashing it, just like this. I have this tool here that helps you grind up the meat, and you don't need it, but it just makes the process a lot easier. So I'll be using it in this video. You just push and twist. That's a cool gadget. All right, now that there is no pink left, what I'm going to do is take 2/3 cup of water and pour it into the meat, just like this. Now what I'm going to do is get my taco seasoning. So I am using this taco seasoning. It's the mild taco seasoning from Taco Bell, but I also like to use the taco seasoning from Trader Joe's, or you can use any taco seasoning that you want. I'm just gonna open it up and pour the packet in. Just like this. Once you pour the whole packet in, you're just gonna mix it just like this. Starting to all mix up, and you want all of the meat to get covered in this delicious taco sauce. Just like that. And then the meat is done. I'm just gonna turn the burner off and move it back here for it to cool off. Now that the taco meat is done, we're gonna start cooking the tortillas. So I'm gonna get a frying pan, just like this one, and put it on the burner. And I'm going to get some butter, or you can use olive oil, but I personally like to use butter. And I'm just going to put a tablespoon of oil or butter into my pan. So what I'm gonna do is just take a spatula and just spread it all around like this. You want it to cover the whole pan. Just like that. Sound. careful when you're not using the stove to not touch the pan because it's very hot, or leave your utensils like this, because what could happen is they could melt, like this one, it's rubber, or it could get really hot, and when you pick it up, it could burn, you could burn yourself. So you do not want that. All right, so now that all of the butter's melted, it's starting to sizzle. I'm gonna turn it down a little bit more because I don't want it to get too hot and burn or turn into brown butter, because no one wants that. I'm gonna take my corn tortillas. You can use corn tortillas or you can use flour tortillas, but today I'm gonna be using corn tortillas. And you're just gonna take one and put it right onto your pan. So I have some tongs here, which will help me be able to flip it, but you could also take a spatula and flip them when they're ready to be flipped. So I'm just gonna cover it in butter and wait for one of the sides to get golden brown. So you can see that when it starts to kind of inflate. Oh, you can kind of see it. It's hard to see. Let's see. You can kind of see it starting to bubble. And there's a bunch of little bubbles. And once it gets really bubbly, you can flip it over. All right, so I put my tortilla in, and then I flipped it over so it can all get covered in butter, and you're gonna see it start to bubble up, which is perfectly fine. And you can use some tongs. I have tongs here, which will help me flip it, or you can just use a regular spatula for flipping, but you're gonna wanna wait until it's nice and golden brown. You can tell by kinda peeking it up like this and seeing if it's ready. So this one's not quite ready yet. And then when it's golden brown, you can flip it and wait for the other side to get golden brown. You want it to be golden brown so it's nice and crispy. If it's not golden brown, then it's not crispy yet. All right, here we go. This side's nice and golden brown and crispy. So we're gonna wait for it to do with the other side. And then we're gonna put it on a plate lined with paper towel for all the oil to drip out. So I got some paper towel that I'm just gonna put onto this plate. And now my tortilla is done. It's nice and crispy. I'm going to carefully put it on the plate, just like this. And then I'm gonna go ahead and make 9 more because you want 10 tortillas. That all of my tortillas are cooked, we are gonna assemble the pizza. So you're gonna start by taking a tortilla and placing it onto your pan. And you're gonna get some red taco sauce. It says on the recipe that you can use canned, but my family likes to use this one. And we're just going to pour a little bit on to the tortilla. And you're gonna spread it just like you would spread pizza sauce on a pizza, or like how we spread pizza sauce on the pizza wreath that we made last month. Next, what we're gonna do is put some cheese on. So I have some Mexican style cheese blend, and I'm just going to sprinkle it on top just like that. All right, I put the cheese on, and now I'm gonna get a scoop of the meat and just sprinkle it on top of the tortilla, just like that. And you can put other toppings on, like here I have some refried beans. Just scoop on. This is all optional. You can do whatever you want or that you like. You can customize it however you would like. Then, after I put all my toppings on, I'm going to put another tortilla on top and press down, just like that. All right, and then what you're gonna do is put another thin layer of taco sauce on the top, and then you're gonna sprinkle more cheese on the top, just like this. And then You're gonna place it in the oven for 10 minutes. Alexa, set an alarm for 10 minutes. Now that it's in the oven, time to clean up.
We don't talk about Bruno, no, no, no. We don't talk about
Taste test. That's so good. It's like a taco pizza. Ten recommend. Thank you so much for cooking with me. I had so much fun. I hope you did too. Hope you enjoy.
We don't talk about Bruno.